EA Sports. It's in the game.
We attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the option. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in a slot. Trying to get in. All you want to do is talk. I don't need talk.
I don't hurt somebody talk.
I can pull up with that. Chewbacca that. Banging my chest and my head on the lock. Feeling like walking flock of flame. I put the opposition out the game. I'm out of pocket, but I rock with the game.
Super Bowl 52 champions, Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. Just a short time ago, these Philly fans in full roar as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. Pyrotechnics ablaze. They're set to go as their Eagles will match up with the Cincinnati Bengals. Here's the kicker, Jake Elliott, ready to get this one started. And off we go from Lincoln Financial Field. The former second-round pick, this is Joe Mixon. And he's got some space here. He's at the 40, the 20,
one play at a time.
10,
here we go.
5, and all the way in for a Cincinnati score.
So there, Charles, I mean, a situation where it didn't matter how far he had to run, he was not going to be denied, and he winds up taking this all the way to the end zone. Evan McPherson for the extra point.
Oh, and now they're going to fake it. Toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete. I thought the days of the fake extra point were numbered once they moved these kicks back to the 15. Apparently, I was mistaken.
Yeah, I was wondering who was ever going to try to do this. In fact, I quit wondering. I didn't think it would ever happen. Taking a fake from the 15-yard line to try and pick up an extra point, I didn't think anyone would ever call this.
Devontae Smith now from his end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10 at their own 17-yard line.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. Dancing to his left. They'll get 5 out of the scramble. It's second down. They will run for the first time with Miles Sanders. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. Right back to Sanders on first down. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. From the 38, Hurts escaping the pressure right. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45.
Offensively, they liked their situation, so they tried to take a shot downfield, but no one was open. So it was tuck it in run time, and he picks up a first down.
Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Hurts a handoff to Sanders. And across midfield he goes and into Bengal territory. On third down, they turn to Sanders, and he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. And no move to get the offense off the field. They'll stay put on fourth and 1. Throwing is Hurts. Steps away to his left.
And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30.
Well, that was man coverage. So once he decides to run with the football, there's no one to account for him, and he turns it into a nice gain.
On first and 10, it's Hurts.
He'll buy some time right. And this is caught at the 8.
And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. Off the play fake, here's Hurts. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. Down this close to the goal line, first down. Surprised that wasn't a run?
I am, and you know I'm old school. I want to run the ball on first down in this situation because second down, that gives me an option of running play action and maybe throwing it.
Let's get off the field, G. On second and goal, Hurts. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
I think that's how this defense is going to need to play these tight ends. Again, get right up on them and stay physical. And that paid off on that play, helping force that incompletion.
They'll look to throw on third and goal. And this is caught. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Miles Sanders there to make the grab. And the Eagles are now just an extra point away from grabbing the lead. There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
Elliott good on the extra point, and they take the lead here at 7-6. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Brandon Wilson to return it. And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30. Bengals drive about to get going. And they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Partner, I love your description because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about a passing play, aren't we? Something in the air, deep ball. But how about them just taking it big time jaunt? Now if you're coming back out, now they've established this run game, the play action pass could very well be open.
The throw down the field, caught by his running back. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. Throwing now, Burrow on first down. His throw incomplete.
One of the best routes, one of the favorite routes of any play caller. He just ran that one. Nice little angle route. That's supposed to be a catch, and usually it is in running back drop.
Yeah, I mean, he's a running back, but he's got hands. He should have caught it. Space to run past the 20, and all the way down to the 17-yard line. They'll get 14 on that one. Good for a Bengal first down. Burrow bats it forward. It's a jet sweep. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. After one, a one-point game, 7-6. Now it's Burrow. This goes out wide from Mixon. So nothing doing there. And it'll be second and goal.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
And he'll be stopped up after only a couple of yards as he gets it down to the 5.
Well, Brandon, we always know that once you score one touchdown,
you want two.
You're without a doubt. And so far today, he's got one, but was denied as he tried to get the second one.
Eluding the pressure right. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Bengal TD. Joe Burrow, a 5-yard touchdown run. And the Bengals are going to jump back in front. And now they'll empty the backfield here as they elect to go for two. And Burrow's going to look to throw for it.
Flush to his right. And this will be caught as they convert here for two. And I guess that makes up for the earlier missed two-point try here to get him to 14.
Yeah, that aggressiveness, it reminds me a lot of when basketball first adopted the three-point shot. And people were starting to realize that 3-for-2 was really starting to work for them. In this case now, maybe the 2-for-1 is coming into play in the NFL.
At the line, this Philly offense set to go. And now last drive, so successful with the ground game, ending in a touchdown. Do you stick with that formula?
That would be the number one thing you would think of, but so many guys now would look at it and say, we've got them set up so well for play action, now's the time to take a shot.
Yeah.
But you know, there was a big time coach in the state of Ohio who once said, if you throw the ball, if you put it in the air, three things can happen, and two of them are bad.
Is that Woody
Hayes?
Would
have kissed it on the ground.
And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27. Hurts rolling to his right, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Sam Hubbard able to get him down for a loss of 11, and it brings up fourth down. And the punt team on now as this one's sent away. And he can't field it cleanly. It's loose.
And that's what friends are for.
As the returner, you know who you're buying dinner for later.
Oh, without a doubt, because he just took care of you and your team in a big way. You know, you turn it over there, that's a big momentum changer and put your defense in a bad spot.
Here's Joe Mixon as they start on the ground. And down he goes at the 45 after a pickup of 9.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Back to Mixon on second down. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. 94 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this first half. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the second quarter, 14-7. A reminder, coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report, but business to take care of before we get there.
A 2-minute drill before the coach's 2-minute drill.
A gain of 6 there on first.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
Second down at 4. Now it's Burrow. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Well, we always talk about how you've got to be quick when you go through your progressions, and here's another prime example. Trying to look downfield, he's standing in the pocket, but just couldn't find anyone open, could he?
No, not enough time. They hit him and forced that incompletion. And he is going to have a Bengals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
And he will take it on in for a Bengals touchdown. Joe Burrow with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Bengals are able to grow their lead. So simple math here in the first half. They've had 3 drives offensively, and they have scored every time, and they've got the lead.
Well, whenever we talk about adjustments, we usually talk about an offense making adjustments, right? This is all about the defense. They've got to figure out some way.
Oh, and now they're going to fake it. And he'll be out of bounds well short of the goal line, so the attempt at the fake extra point unsuccessful. So after the made field goal, here's McPherson to send this one away. And he can't field it cleanly. It's loose. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And with him down two scores, you wonder if they might try and put something together, even if it's just to get into field goal range.
And some room to roam now. The 40. 20. And he just falls short down at the 1 yard line. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. We know he's good at catching the football, but then after the catch, he's got escapability.
Not only that, he's got some toughness as well, because you know he's coached very hard to make sure he battles through, breaks tackles, and then they finish with, but don't fumble the football.
Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. Second down and goal. Hurts open. Man, he's got him. That's Smith for the Philadelphia touchdown. Devontae Smith in the final seconds of the first half. And the Eagles are able to cut into this lead in the final seconds of the first half. They'll throw now on the final play. And they're going to get the two-point conversion caught in the end zone. And that cuts the lead a bit further. Boy, they're down only one score. Still first half. But they're going to line up for the onside kick. And this is going to be snuffed out. The Bengals recover. A second quarter onside kick there that failed. Is that something that maybe they had dialed up before this game started?
It feels like it, doesn't it? That they thought they had the right situation, you know, and the right approach in going after it. Also may signal that they feel like they have the superior team, that they can try these sorts of things and it won't come back and hurt them later.
He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And that is incomplete. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break.
Both these teams making their final halftime adjustments. We're just about ready to get back to football. So for the call of the second half, we get back up to Philadelphia and Brandon Gott.
And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gott, getting set for quarter number three here. It's the Eagles ready to see the football first, and they trail here as we resume action in this third quarter. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
The Eagles take over first and 10.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And they're on the short end of the scoreboard here. Charles, what adjustments, if any, do you think they need to make for the second half?
Well, paraphrasing the gold medal hockey winning coach Herb Brooks, I just say you continue to play your game. Throw the ball. They had success doing it in the first half. So make sure you keep getting the ball to your playmakers, a little bit more to the perimeter perhaps. But above all, play your game.
Now a deep ball going to be caught here near midfield. And he is finally out of bounds, but not before taking it down inside the 30. A big play there for Philly. Every defensive staff harps on limiting explosive plays. Job not so well done there.
Yeah, they talk about it all the time. A lot harder to stop, though, isn't it? And when you think of an explosive play, most offensive staffs define them as passes of 20 or more yards and runs of
touchdown, Eagles. Dallas Goedert, 28 yards. And the Eagles have retaken the lead.
And what a weapon he is at the tight end spot, because when they throw him the football downfield, they count on him getting additional yardage almost every time. And that's exactly what he did there. Caught that, ran with it, all the way to the end zone.
They'll turn to Sanders, and he will not make it to the goal line here. So they'll be unable to bump this lead up to a field goal as it remains a one-point game. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Kicks it on the ground with a squib, taken around the 28. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Bengals drive about to get going. And Charles, they trail here, though not really the fault of this offense.
No, they certainly did their part in the first half. But when you're in a shootout like this, You definitely want your defense to play better, but you know that's out of your control. All you can do, keep putting points on the scoreboard and keep giving your defense opportunities to make stops.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
A gain of six there on first. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
They'll roll him out right. Here's Higgins out on the right side.
They talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
Eagle pressure, too much this time. Down he goes. Javon Hargrave, the D tackle, getting the sack. So now they operate back from their side of the field here, second and long. Another try after the first down sack. Burrow, they'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets them up for third down.
Well, it certainly feels like there are more stars at the tight end position than there were even 10 years ago. And I think it's become more of a glamour position because of the ways it can hurt a defense, and guys want to be involved. They can be in line, close to the line of scrimmage. They can split out like receivers. But hands, route running, speed, and some toughness to go across the middle, you put it all together, you got a heck of a tight end candidate.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. Flushed out right. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far at second down. A third quarter now, and a one-point game as they line up second and 10. Throwing again, it's Burrow. They'll set up the screen here to Mixon. And they go the wrong way here. Knocked back to the 20. They'll wind up losing three here on the play. And that'll make it third and 13. Here's Burrow setting up to throw it, sliding out of the pocket. Hard throw, incomplete.
I know he was trying to get the completion downfield, but the way this game has gone, with a few of the runs he's made along the way, he should have kept the ball and taken it with his feet downfield. That's the big play that shreds a defense. Instead, he thought to himself, I'm a quarterback, I've got to throw it. He bailed out the defense with that incompletion.
McPherson's kick is good. And with that, the lead changes hands here in this third quarter. So they wind up turning the turnover into points as they convert there for three.
Yeah, that was a nice job there to force the fumble. They recover, hand things over to their offense, and then the offense went down and got them three. That alone, that's not enough to win a game, but both units able to do their jobs on these last two drives.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They'll fake the give to Sanders, and now Hurts. And his throw here is incomplete. Well, those two have hooked up for a touchdown once already in this game, that time unable to find the completion.
Yeah, it just appeared they wanted to get him out into open space and try and get him the football. As you mentioned, unable to connect.
He'll buy some time right. 6 yards there off the scramble, but it'll still leave him with a third down. Three quarters have come and gone. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Eagles on third down, just one for three thus far. This is third and four. On the counter now, it's Sanders. And he's able to get it to the 31, and that's enough for the first. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Here's Hurts to throw, being chased out left. And Hurts able to show off some of that elusiveness as he slides to the ground there and in the process picks up the first down. On first and 10, it's Sanders. And that one blown up quickly as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down. All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off near the 42. There he goes, right side. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six for a Bengals TD. So now it appears they're going to accept the penalty, which means take away the interception. Also means keep your defense on the field. Don't understand this one bit. But first down, Hurts forced out to his left. Open man is Goddard, the tight end. 3 yards the gain there, second down. Play action, here's Hurts. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Logan Wilson, credit him with a sack as he buries him for a loss of 10. A field goal from this spot likely out of the question. They've got to get closer here on third down. Hurts sets up to throw it. That swung out wide to Sanders. And he'll get it down here to the 43. He did his best to just get four out of that, but not enough. And now fourth down. And Hurts not coming to the sideline. They're going to go for it. They'll try and throw for it with Hurts. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Eagles unable to convert there on fourth, and the Bengals will get the football back. Burrow going to lead up the Bengals here, first and 10 at their own 43. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive, escaping the pressure right. Throw right side into the hands of the tight end, Sample. 3 yards remain for second down. From midfield now, Burrow buying time to his left. Inside of 2 minutes remaining in a two-point ball game. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Shreds the tackle, and this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. Another yard would probably put this thing in the books. It's second and one. Again, it's Mixon, and he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they'll get it with just over 90 seconds to go in the ball game. They'll roll him out right, and that nearly the pick that they needed. He couldn't pull it in, though, and it's fourth down.
They went with the dime look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
McPherson's kick is good, and the drive will wind up yielding 3. So they get the 3, but you wonder now, is that going to be enough?
Excellent question, because when I look at the smiles on that side of the field, they're a little tight, aren't they? If they had scored a touchdown.
And he can't field it cleanly. It's loose. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. They're down here in a one-score game, but the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences, and this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late-game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They've called these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
Well, they have the opportunity now. Here's the execution. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Here's second and 10. Back to throw. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Third and long coming up defensively. You pressure the quarterback or drape all over the passing lane?
Yes, that's exactly what you do. It's both because they're not mutually exclusive. They may have been at one time in football, but not anymore. You want to have that pressure. If you have a big-time pass rusher, send him after the quarterback.
And gets through, and now an opening. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and we watch him drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know, this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed, too.
And just not enough on the throw there, down around his feet and incomplete.
Whew, that's certainly not the worst thing. It stops the clock and lets your offense catch its breath and lets us exhale a little bit. Now I expect them to call a couple plays in the huddle so they're ready if a tackle happens inbounds.
It's caught by Sanders. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. Play number 7 now coming up on the drive. 3rd and 5. Back to throw. And this nearly intercepted. Probably should have been. Had he caught it, it would have sealed it. Instead, one more chance coming up on 4th down. And down by 5, they've got to go for it here on 4th down. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and the Bengals are going to get it back in terrific field position. Mixon with a 1st down carry. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. Now the Eagles will use the 2nd of their timeouts as they get it with 16 seconds remaining on the clock. Back to Mixon on 2nd down. And he's taken down inside the 30. And here come the whistles and a timeout with 7 seconds left. And he works his way past the line of scrimmage and then slides to a halt. And we will get a timeout with 2 ticks left. Oh, now look at this. They're lining up to add 3 more, little insult to injury here late in the game. From the left hash, it's a 42-yard attempt. So this one in the win column now for the Cincinnati Bengals. And you look back over the score sheet, interesting. A very clean game, no turnovers by either side.
An absolute rarity when we watch games now because defenses have put such an emphasis on taking the ball away. Well, what we saw here was offenses spending their time saying, look, you know they're coming for it. Ball security is paramount. So they worked on that, not just the week of practice, but I'm sure all during training camp. Make sure when you have it, tuck it away because danger lurks everywhere you turn.